हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल। एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थैंक यू सो मच फॉर द ग्रेट रिस्पॉन्स यू हैव शोन बाय शेयरिंग द वीडियोज, बाय पोस्टिंग योर कमेंट्स एंड बाय सब्सक्राइबिंग टू द चैनल। आई वॉज नॉट एक्सपेक्टिंग सच काइंड ऑफ अ रिस्पॉन्स इन लेस देन 2 months ओनली। सो थैंक यू सो मच अगेन। एंड इफ यू आर सीइंग दिस वीडियो फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल सो दैट further when we upload the next video you will get the notification and you won't miss any video while preparing for the competitive exams in architecture and planning. So first of all, sorry there was a delay of let's say 2 months for uploading this new lecture. Many of you have requested in the comment box section that yes, thank you for the videos and post more videos of similar nature. So I'm trying my level best to make more videos to help you while preparing for the exams. So in this particular lecture, we are going to discuss about the answers to the queries raised by few of you while watching the videos. So I will try to solve your doubts by the question and answers in this particular video. So one by one we will see what are the queries raised by the students and what are the comments. I have taken few comments from the comment box section and I would like to solve your doubts based on the questions. So Darshit Vora is saying, sir, learnt a lot from the video lecture. Please make a video on all list of recruitment exams and their basic information. Okay, Darshit, thank you so much. We are going to discuss about this list of recruitment exam and their basic information in this particular video. Sampada is saying, sir, can you please make video on government job after clearing GATE examination? Yes. This particular video, you will get the information about the government jobs. Not necessary, you should appear after clearing the GATE exam. You can appear before the GATE examination also. So the next question is posted by Jaya. She's saying, sir, please make video on DDA planning assistant. Jaya, I don't have this particular paper of planning assistant. If you have it, if you have appeared for this exam, please send me the question paper. I will provide my email ID in the description box. But from my side, my opinion will be, see, it is not possible to make a video on each and every recruitment exam. Like we have seen in the first lecture, while giving the description about the preparation strategy for the competitive exams, more or less at a national level, when central government agencies, they are recruiting architects and planners, their question papers are generally dependent on the GATE exam. So if you think there are few questions which were not related to the earlier GATE questions, you can send me the those questions and I will try to provide the answers to those questions based on my experience. So I don't have this particular question paper. Otherwise, we will definitely we will make a video on various recruitment exams. Then Ranjit is saying, I had your book. It helped me to clear GATE 2018. Okay, Ranjit, it is very wonderful thing and thank you so much for posting your reply. Aditi is saying, thank you so much, sir, for this video. Aditi, welcome. And I'm happy to read your comments. Akshat, again, he is saying that very helpful video. Thank you for this video. Thank you, Akshat, for your wonderful reply. Joita is saying, this is very helpful. I would request you to make more videos. Yes, Joita, I'm trying my level best. There was a slight delay because I was busy in my some other work. So, as and when time is permitting me, I'm making this video so that you know you people will get the benefit of the knowledge we will share in this video lectures. Urmila, her comment is, thank you so much, sir. Welcome, Urmila. Your first book has helped me a lot for the preparation, but I'm facing more problem in numerical solving type questions related to housing, CPM and PERT, contours, conductivity, angular projection, estimation, transmission loss, perpetuity, profit loss, sinking fund, etc. Need more questions related to this for practice and understanding the tricks and logics. So I think you have enlisted all the types of numerical problems generally asked in the GATE question papers. But I don't have information whether you are appearing for the GATE exam for the first time or not. see, we are going to discuss about these common numerical problems in the further lectures. I would like to reveal first that in the next lecture we are going to discuss about the numerical problems related to the reverberation problems. But my advice will be, if you are facing the problem in numerical type questions, I would request you to enlist all these similar problems in your notebook. Just try to understand what is the relation between them. Just try to revise the formula. And as I said in the first lecture, while solving the GATE 2020 question paper, you need to put your own values in that questions and try to solve such 10 different 10 such questions by putting your own values. I think this is the very good strategy for practicing and for having a command in the numerical problems. So we are going to discuss about these numerical problems in the further lectures. And this is the trick or logic which I had said. You need to solve multiple questions by putting your own values. Kushagra has commented that, thank you so much, sir. I am a student of architecture in second year right now, and I hope that with the help of you, I am able to crack this exam. Thank you so much, sir. Okay, welcome, Kushagra. And you are in second year, so you have started preparing for GATE very early, and it is a very wonderful thing. You won't be able to appear in the GATE 2022, because third year onwards, you can appear in the GATE exam. So no issues, you can appear in the GATE 2023, and it will help you to further improve your score till your final year. So yes, both these books, Architect Guidebook for Competitive Exam Set 1 and Set 2, will help you to prepare for the GATE examination. Rahul Kumar, he's saying, sir, please make more videos. Yes, Rahul, I'm trying my level best to make more videos. So based on this, as a few of you in the earlier slide, as I said, that many of you have requested, sir, please provide the information about which are the recruitment exams we can appear, which are of similar nature, or we can appear after graduation or after clearing the GATE examination. See, my advice will be, GATE is not the certain a step while appearing for the competitive exam. At the same time, if while preparing for the GATE exam, your preparation for these competitive exams is also going on, because in the first lecture we have said that we have discussed that more or less the syllabus for competitive exams and GATE exam is more or less same. So one can appear for the competitive exam very confidently if you have a good command in while preparing in the GATE exam. So the answers to those queries, that which are the recruitment exam we can appear, and what is the information related to those recruitment exam, I have listed this in this particular table. That the recruitment exam for architects and planners, I have divided into the two types, like the recruitment exams conducted by central government and recruitment exams conducted by the state government. This is based on the past examination which I have seen, the notification I have seen for this examination in, let's say, past 4 or 5 years. So basically, first exam, the recruitment exam, which is conducted by UPSC. So the central government organization, for example, CPWD, Military Engineering Services, or any such central government body, they are requesting UPSC to conduct a exam for recruitment of architects in that particular organization. So UPSC generally conduct that exam, and after the result, these successful candidates, they can join this organization at a group A or group B post. So recently, there was a notification in 2000, if I'm not wrong, there was a notification in GATE in the year 2017 for the post of Deputy Architect, which is a Group A post in Military Engineering Services. Before that, in 2016 or 17, I'm not sure, there was a notification for Deputy Architect post as well as Assistant Architect post in the CPWD, which is Central Public Work Department. So UPSC is conducting recruitment exam for these two posts, Deputy Architect, which is a Group A post, and Assistant Architect, which is a Group B post. For this particular two post, there is for the deputy architect post, you will require experience of 2 years. For the assistant architect, I'm not sure about, but a fresher can also appear for this assistant architect paper. The next exam is the exams conducted by the ISRO for the post of architect. If you have seen the question papers in the set 1 of Architects Guidebook, there are question papers, let's say from year 2015-16 till the year 2019. So let's say every year ISRO is conducting the recruitment exam for the post of architect. Generally, they call it as a post for the scientist, which is a group A post, similar like a deputy architect post. Their exam is conducted separately. It is not conducted by UPSC or something, the other organization. As it is an autonomous body, they are conducting their own exam. The exam, the question paper is generally very easy. If you have seen the questions, there are 3 to 4 years questions, question papers already available in the guidebook. So again, they are based on the gate question papers or few questions of general aptitude. They are also very easy to solve. But a very basic condition they generally put in the notification that candidates having aggregate 60% and above in all the 5 years, only they can apply for this particular post. So if you have like aggregate 60%, more than 60%, you can appear in the in this particular exam conducted by ISRO. Then next is Delhi Development Authority. Again, this is an autonomous body under central government. They are conducting recruitment exam for the post of assistant director in the architecture section, assistant director in the planning section. Both these posts, they are group A post, and architectural assistant and planning assistant, these are group B post. So what is the requirement or what is the qualification required for the assistant director architecture? BArch plus you need a master's in architecture in any field, master's in landscape, master's in urban design, or if you have a building engineering management degree, a master's degree, it is also applicable for the post of assistant director architecture. For the post of assistant director planning, you will require BArch or BPlan plus you required a master's in planning. That planning degree should be recognized by the ITPI. So planning in housing, planning in urban planning, regional planning, also the master's is eligible, but that course should be recognized by the ITPI. For the architectural assistant and planning assistant, both BRs, for the architectural assistant, you will require a qualification of BRs. For the planning assistant, BRs as well as BPlan student, they are also eligible. So these are group B post. I won't go into detail what is the pay scale and all those things. You will get the information if you search about this post on the DDA website. The next organization is DMRC. DMRC is also conducting candidate for the post of deputy manager and as well as senior manager. Generally in PSU, they used to rank the pay scale in the series of E1, E2, E3 and like that. So E1, it is a basic like the starting level, which is the post known as deputy manager. The other organization like public sector undertakings, generally known as PSUs, like HUDCO, NBCC, BEL, they have recently, in the earlier few years, they have conducted the recruitment exam for the post of architect. So again, they don't call the post as an architect. They have, you know, deputy manager in the architectural section, which is an E1 post, and senior manager, which is like two level above this post, which is an E3 post. So NBCC in the year 2017, they conducted the exam for the post of senior manager in the architectural section. Generally, the number is not large. Like in the year 2016 or 17, HUDCO conducted the exam for the only 5 number of posts in the architectural section, whereas NBCC conducted the recruitment exam only for the 1 post. So the competition is very tough here in the public sector undertaking the exam. But in this other case, the DDA and UPSC, the number is quite, you know, more than 15 or 16 candidates were selected, were notified, like the total number of candidates required was more than 15 in for the group A post. And I think for the group B post in DDA, there was around 40, more than 40 candidates were required. So basically, and then the next is directly through gate in PSUs. So if you have read about that, many PSUs in the core engineering field, like the mechanical engineering, computer engineering, electronics, and all the other fields, many PSUs, they directly recruit the candidates based on their GATE score in the engineering field. But it is not happening in the architectural section. But there was an exception that earlier Airport Authority of India had earlier in 2017 or 18, I'm not sure about the particular year, but they had recruited the architects based on the GATE score of that particular year. So, like I said, that it is a regular practice for the other PSUs, they directly recruit the engineers based on their GATE score, but it is not happening in the architectural and planning section for the GATE exam. So basically, these are the rough, rough comparison about which recruitment exam you can appear for various posts after, like, which are of similar nature of GATE exam, or you can appear while preparing for the GATE exam. Then next is the state government, the recruitment exam conducted by the state government. So these recruitment exam in the state government, they are conducted by Public Service Commission, Town Planning Department, or regional and development authorities. So which are these posts? The posts are known as Assistant Town Planners, Planning Assistant, Assistant Architect, and Architectural Assistant. So the various department which recruits the Assistant Town Planners and Planning Assistant or Assistant Architectural Assistant are Town Planning Department, Development Bodies, PWD Department, Municipal Corporations, etc. So recently, if you like to discuss about this, which are the exams conducted based on this, there was an exam conducted recently, I think not more than 10 days before, Rajasthan government, they conducted an exam for the Assistant Town Planner post. The question paper is available on their website. Before that, in the last year, there was a recruitment of for the post of Assistant Town Planner in Haryana government. Before that, there was a recruitment exam conducted in the Jharkhand. So generally, you need to be careful about the notification. Read the notification thoroughly and have a touch with the basic news or the advertisements generally posted in the local newspapers. So please go through those advertisements and have a look daily. Go through if generally the national level recruitment exam also notified in the newspapers. So do have a touch. Do read the newspapers. There are a few websites available where you will get the information about the upcoming recruitment exams. So do have a look at those sources. Then next is Metro Rail Corporation. Like in, let's say, more than 20 to 25 cities, the Metro Rail work is going on right now in India. So based on the requirement, these Metro Rail Corporations, they also conduct the recruitment exam for the post of architect and senior architect, also for the planners. So this is a rough comparison of which are the exams where you can appear after your graduation and while preparing for the GATE architecture and planning, because more or less the exams are based on the similar syllabus. So I hope I have solved the queries raised by I think 2-3 people, that which are the recruitment exams, please give the details. So do have a look about the past question papers if you get from somewhere from your seniors, and do go through those question papers. And again, I will advise you that the set 2, which is based on the GATE syllabus, it comprises of entire syllabus based on the topics mentioned in the GATE syllabus, so which will be helpful for you for appearing in these recruitment exams conducted by various government organizations. I will first like to reveal about which is the next lecture we are going to discuss, that we are going to discuss about the frequently asked numerical questions in building acoustics. These questions are generally very easy to solve. One should not lose marks in such simple questions, and generally they carry 1 or 2 marks based on what is the difficulty level. So in the next lecture, we are going to about the numerical questions in the building acoustics. So till that time, do prepare hard, right now the application process for GATE 2022 is about to end, so don't wait till the last day and do apply for the exam well before in time, well before the deadline. And again, I will advise, just start preparing as soon as possible and give your best. I wish you all the best and we will meet in the next lecture. Thank you so much. If you like the video, please comment, please share this video with your friends and do subscribe to the channel. Thank you.